Honest Katsime, aged 28, a spouse to Edward Walugembe Chiwalianga, residing from Kusu, landing site discovered the shocking news from a week-long health and dental medical outreach held in Kalangala district earlier this week. I felt ill for a moment. I then bled, but I was really scared because I was pregnant. I then went to a local clinic where I got some medication. I had plans of going to Kalangala Health Center for, but due to hardships in transport, I failed. I had got information that there would be a medical camp in Chitoro, so I decided to go there on that fateful day to access scan services so that I would rule out any fears. But unfortunately, they told me that my twins were already dead and I needed immediate evacuation from the island for further management. From Buyovu Islands that access antenatal services at Vufumira Health Center 3, a pregnant mother requires 10 liters of fuel, which costs 60,000 shillings, hire coxswain at 30,000 shillings, hire a boat and engine at 50,000 shillings.
The cost of health services in Kalangala, too high.
Katsime was then referred to Kalangala Health Center 4 for further treatment, where she received a couple of medical services. She was induced in order to save her life. During this medical outreach, a number of islands also benefited from the services.
The baseline investigations, and then we had to induce labor so that we can remove the babies who are dead already in the pregnancy or in the uterus of this mother. So we did induction of labor, and then we expelled the fetus which were dead.
The situation I'm going through is not easy because I don't have anyone to help me, yet I can't also access health services at any time I need it. The Kalangala Health and Dental Medical Outreach is held by Kalangala Health Center 4 in partnership with Bridge to Health Global from US and Canada. This is always coupled with basic medical services including scanning, surgery and operations, general diagnosis, dental services, among others. Dr. Michael Suna explains the conditions that were mostly diagnosed. He further says that they have plans to organize more camps.
Now we are having camps once a year. Mega camps, because there is a lot that goes into this, resources, mobilization of health workers, equipment, and the medicine. But our plan is to see that we have as many camps as possible, because there is a high demand of services.
Caroline Tracy, the Bridge to Health CEO, has appealed to different partners to join them as they bring services nearer to islanders.
It's the hardest aspect here because we're dealing with a very low resource setting. We're also dealing with very remote islands, and as I mentioned, accessibility is our number one challenge. The way that we're thinking about it is trying to improve the capacity of the local team. So that's what's really important. We want to make sure that when we're here, it's really education-based and training-based, so that skill transfer remains in the island. And
over $50,000 has been invested in this camp. This has catered for allowances for doctors from US and Canada, purchase of drugs, transportation of health workers to different stations of work, transporting dental assortments, among others. Story compiled by Samuel Nkuba for the news.